And now we know that tooth and hair share common developmental and structural features. But one important thing to keep in mind is that while hair is regenerated throughout the lifespan of the individual, the teeth have basically two phases, primary teeth and permanent teeth. And knowing that cavities is the most chronic common disease worldwide, understanding the factors that lead to having a higher susceptibility to develop cavities is really important. That's where the relevance of our findings comes in. We show that mutations in a hair keratin, keratin 75, that has been associated with hair disorders, is present, and mutations in this keratin are associated with development of enamel dental defects and a higher susceptibility to develop caries. All of this leads us to really is just establishing a much more proactive type of approach in which patients that carry these mutations in hair keratins now know that they probably have a higher susceptibility for cavities, and going more regularly to the dentist in ways to prevent cavities from forming or to progress when they are still small will be of high advantage. And more so, I think it really establishes the importance of the interface or the of how these findings overlap the genetics of fields such as dermatology and dentistry.